गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस्ड कंसंट्रेशन. व्हाट इज द कंसंट्रेशन? द अमाउंट ऑफ सॉल्यूट प्रेजेंट इन ए सॉल्यूशन वी कॉल्ड एज कंसंट्रेशन. द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन कैन बी एक्सप्रेस्ड बाय यूजिंग डिफरेंट टर्म्स. ओके, दोज आर मास परसेंटेज, वॉल्यूम परसेंट, स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन, मोलारिटी, मोलालिटी, नॉर्मालिटी, मोल फ्रैक्शन, फॉर्मालिटी. इन दोज वी हैव वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वन. एक्सेप्ट फॉर्मालिटी एंड नॉर्मालिटी, हियर वी डिस्कस ऑल दोज सिक्स कॉन्सेंट्रेशन टर्म्स ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस. ओके, हियर फर्स्ट आई वांट टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मास परसेंट. फर्स्ट वन, मास परसेंट. दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड वेट परसेंट. ओके, दिस इंडिकेट विथ परसेंट मीन्स परसेंटेज, वेट बाई वेट, स्मॉल डब्ल्यू बाई कैपिटल डब्ल्यू, वेट बाई वेट. ओके, वॉट इज द प्रिंसिपल फॉर दैट? ओके, हाउ वी कैलकुलेट द मास परसेंटेज ऑफ द सोल्यूट और वेट परसेंटेज ऑफ सोल्यूट? ओके, बाय यूजिंग मास परसेंट. ओके, हियर मास परसेंट लाइक दिस. हियर वेट ऑफ सोल्यूट. ओके, वेट ऑफ सोल्यूट बाय वेट ऑफ सोल्यूशन. वेट ऑफ सोल्यूशन, वेट ऑफ सोल्यूट बाय वेट ऑफ सोल्यूशन इंटू 100. बाय यूजिंग दिस प्रिंसिपल वी विल कैलकुलेट द मास परसेंट. द रेशियो बिटवीन द परसेंटेज एंड रेशियो बिटवीन वेट ऑफ सोल्यूट एंड वेट ऑफ सोल्यूशन वी कॉल्ड एज मास परसेंट और वेट परसेंट. ओके, हियर जस्ट आई वॉन्ट टू राइट द वन प्रॉब्लम हियर बेस्ड ऑन दिस. 2 grams of A compound dissolved. Here I am writing problem. 2 grams of A compound dissolved in 18 grams of B compound. 18 grams of B compound. Okay, here calculate mass percent. Calculate mass percent. How we calculate the mass percent? First, before seeing that, you should know about the weight of solute and weight of solution. Then only you calculate the mass percent. Okay, here solute means which is less in solution. Okay, which is present as a less amount, we call as solute. More amount we call as solvent. What is the meaning of solution? Solute plus solvent we call as solution. Here 2 grams, here 18 grams. Which is less? 2 grams is less. So solute is, here I am writing answer. Okay, solute. Okay, solute is, weight of solute is, weight of solute is 2 grams. Weight of solution. Weight of solution. What is the weight of solution? Solution means solute plus solvent. Solute 2 grams plus solvent 18 grams. Total 20. Okay, 20. This is the weight of solution. 20 grams is the weight of solution. Okay, then calculate. What we need here? Weight of solute and weight of solution. Okay, we got weight of solute is 2 grams and weight of solution is 20 grams. Then you calculate the mass percent, weight by weight. Okay, it's a small w, it's a capital W. Small w means weight of solute, capital W means weight of solute and solvent. That means solution. Okay, here 2 by weight of solute is 2, weight of solution is 20 into 100. How much here? 21s are 25s are 2 into 5, 10. Okay, weight percentage is here 10. Weight percentage here 10.
Then we'll see the second one, volume percent. Volume percent. Volume percent means percentage small v by capital V. So get by using it is indicated with the symbol for volume percentage. This is the symbol for volume percentage. Okay, here what is the principle for this? V by V is equal to, okay, volume of solute, volume of solute by volume of solution, volume of solution into 100, into 100. This is the principle for the calculation of volume percentage of solute, volume percentage of solute. Okay, here this is the principle, here this is the principle. Okay, here I want to give the one problem and I want to solve, I want to give and I only solve the problem. Okay, here I am taking 5 ml of ethyl alcohol, 5 ml of ethyl alcohol was dissolved in 20 ml of water, 20 ml of water. Calculate percentage value or value percentage. Calculate value percent or value percent. Value percent. Okay, how we calculate the value percent? How we calculate the value percent? What is the principle for value percent? Okay, here percentage of value. Value small v is a capital V. Small v means volume of the solute. Capital V means volume of the solution. Okay, here it calculated by using this principle. Volume of the solute, volume of the solution into 100. Okay, I gave the one problem. 5 ml of ethyl alcohol. 5 ml of ethyl alcohol was dissolved in 20 ml of water. Calculate, okay, volume percentage. Okay, calculate volume percentage or percentage V by V. Okay, here, what we need? First, volume of this solute. What is the value? Which is solute, which is solvent? Solute means less. Solvent means more. Here 5 ml is there. Here 20 ml is there. Okay, 5 ml solute, 20 ml solvent. 20 ml solvent. Okay, here volume of the solute. Volume of solute. Volume of solute is equal to 5 ml. Volume of, okay, solvent. Volume of solvent. Volume of solvent is 20 ml. Volume of solution. Solution means solute plus solvent. Solute how much? 5 ml. Solvent how much? 20 ml. That means 25 ml. Okay, then percentage V by V is equal to volume of the solute 5. Volume of the solution 25 into 100. 25 ones are 25 fours are. Okay, 5 into 4, 20. Okay, the value percentage is 20. The value percentage is 20. Here, mass percentage. How we calculate the mass percentage? Weight of the solute by weight of the solution into 100. Okay, here I gave the one problem. 2 grams of A dissolved in 18 grams of B compound. Calculate percentage weight by weight. Okay, weight of the solute here, 2 grams. Weight of the solution. Solution means solute plus solvent. 2 plus 18, 20 grams. Okay, then 2 by 20 into 100 is equal to 10 percentage. Okay, 10 percentage. This is about the mass percent and value percent. Okay, in continuation, we'll see the one more. Strength of the solution. How we calculate the strength of the solution? Just, okay, I will give formula. You only calculate. Okay, in classroom we'll do the all those problems.
Okay, just third one, strength of solution. How we calculate the strength of solution? Okay, here strength of solution. Okay, indicates with percentage, weight by value, By using this principle, we have this strength of solution indicated with this symbol. Percentage small w by small w. Okay, how we calculate? Percentage weight by value is equal to weight of solute. Weight of solute by volume of solution. Volume of solution into 100. By using this principle, we will calculate the strength of the solution. Then in continuation, we move into the one more important topic, molarity. This is the important one. First PUC and second PUC, both the present in first PUC, this topic present in first PUC and as well as in second PUC. In second PUC also, okay, from this topic, okay, we get 2 or 3 marks. In first PUC, same, 2 or 3 marks. So, this molarity, what is the meaning of molarity? What is the symbol of molarity? Molarity indicated with capital M. Okay, here, see the definition of molarity. The number of moles of a solute. In continuation, we will see what is the number of moles. The number of moles of a solute present in a 1 liter solution. 1 liter solution called as molarity. The number of moles of a solute present in 1 liter solution called as molarity. The number of moles of solute present in a 1 liter solution we called as molarity. Molarity, what is the symbol for molarity? M. M is equal to, okay, what is the principle? Number of moles of solute present in a value 1 liter solution. 1 liter solution we called as molarity. Okay, here number of moles of a solute indicated with small n. Value of the solution indicated with V in liters. Okay, you should write the liters. Here, I wanted to give the units for this molarity. Okay, normal system and in SI system. Okay, in continuation after this topic, I will discuss about the units of SI unit, what is the SI system, what is the NKS system, what is CZS system. We discuss already. I think the physics started yesterday, all these SI systems, standard systems. Okay, I will discuss after this solution topic. I will discuss the unit. Okay, just I will tell you, remember that one. I will tell here units, you remember, after that we discuss. Okay, number of moles, the units for the number of moles is moles. And here, volume, the units for the volume is normal system liters. In normal system liters. That means, the units for molarity in normal system is moles per liter. Okay, in SI system. Okay, in SI system also, the units for number of moles is moles only. In SI system, the units for value is cc, cubic centimeter. That means in SI system, the units for molarity in SI system, moles per cubic centimeter. Okay, it is also indicated with cc, moles per cc, cubic centimeter. These are the units for the normal units and in SI system. In normal system and in SI system, the units for the molarity. And here you consider as this one first equation. What is that? N by V is the first equation. Okay, then we know about the value 1 liter, 2 liter, 3 liter. What is number of moles? What is the meaning of number of moles? The number of moles of a solution calculated by using this principle. Weight of solute. Okay, definition of this one is the ratio between, definition of number of moles, the ratio between weight of solute and molecular weight of solute. Here we use molecular weight. Weight of solute and molecular weight of solute. Molecular weight of solute. Okay, weight indicated with the W. Molecular weight W indicated with M. Or M. Here weight WT or NWT. Can use any one. Okay, W by M. The second equation. Substitute equation 2 in equation 1. Equation 2 in equation 1. What is the equation 1? M is equal to number of moles of solute. Instead of number of moles of solute, you substitute this one. Weight of solute by molecular weight of solute into 1 by V in liters. 1 by V in liters. This may be written like this now. Okay, W by M into 1 by V in liters. It's a simple form. Okay, this equation for this principle for okay, value is present in liters. In liters. If, for example, if value is present in milliliters, okay, this can be changed. That means, okay, the value 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml. Here we have the 1. Substitute in place of 1 with 1000. Okay, for milliliters. What is the principle for milliliters? What is the principle? M is equal weight by molecular weight into, in place of 1, use 1000. 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml. Okay, so 1000 by V here in milliliters. This is the principle for the molarity. If solution given in A, if solution given in A, milliliters. Or solvent given in A, milliliters. This is in milliliters. Okay, here we have three important principles. What are those? One is this one. If you know the number of moles, direct we calculate the molarity. If you know the weight, we calculate the molarity. If so, value given in liters. If value given in milliliters, we use this one. Okay, in continuation, we'll see some more principles of this molarity. Okay, here. Okay, what is the principle? Here we have the different principles. Three principles are there. Okay, based on those principles, okay, just we discuss some problems. First principle, M is equal to N by W. This is the one principle. One more, M is equal to W by M into 1 by V in liters. This is the one more. Okay, here one more. W by M into 1000 by V in milliliters. Okay, we discussed these principles. Some more principles are there. We discussed the continuation. Okay, here. Calculate. Okay, so we'll see. 2 moles of hydrochloric acid. 2 moles of hydrochloric acid. Present in 4 liter. 2 moles of hydrochloric acid present in 4 liter of water. 4 liter of water. Calculate its molarity. Calculate its molarity. How will you calculate? Okay, direct data given in moles. Direct data given in moles and liter. Na, use this formula. Use this formula. What is that? M is equal to N. What is the N? Number of moles. What is the number of moles? 2 moles. 5. And here present in 4 liters. Here value in liters na. So write 4. 2 by 4 means 1 by 2. 1 by 2 means 0.5. What are the units? Moles. Okay. Per liter. Moles per liter. Moles per cc. You write like that. Anyway. This is the one simple problem. Okay. In examination point of view, they may ask, PU examination point of view, they may ask 1 mark question like this. Or 2 marks question like this. Okay, for 2 marks, 1 mark for principle, 1 mark for calculation. 1 mark for principle and 1 mark for calculation. Okay, continuation, we'll see one more. Okay, here 4 grams of sodium hydroxide. 4 grams of sodium hydroxide was dissolved in 2.5 liters of, okay, simply you take 2 liters of solution or solvent. Calculate molarity. Okay, here that we don't know about the number of moles. We don't know about the number of moles. What data given? 4 grams of sodium hydroxide dissolved in 2 liters of water. Okay, data given in liters na? So use this principle. What? Which principle? Molarity is equal to weight by molecular weight into 1 by million liters. Okay, here I am writing principle. W by M into 1 by V in liters. Okay, V given now. What is V? 2 liters. Okay, W weight. How much? 4 grams. 4 grams. What is M? Molecular weight. How we calculate the molecular weight? Already we know about that principle. Okay, here molecular weight of sodium hydroxide. Okay, here sodium atomic weight. What is the sodium atomic weight? 23. Okay, plus atomic weight of oxygen 60. Atomic weight of hydrogen 1. How much here? 40. Okay, molecular weight. Okay, different units for the molecular weight. Normal system we call grams per mole. Or in SI system, Dalton is there, unit U is there. Okay, As per your remember, use anyone. Okay, here we got data. We have the V, we have the W, we have the M. Then we calculate. This M means molecular weight. Molarity is equal to. Okay, what is the W? 4 grams by, okay, 40. 4 by 40 into 1 by, okay, here 2 liters. 1 by 2. 2, 2 za. 2, 1 za. Here 20. Okay, here we got 1 by 20. 1 by 20 means 0.05 moles per liter. Moles per liter. Okay, this is the calculation. Okay. This is the one more problem. Okay, here. If data given in milliliters, Okay, here I am getting 5.85 grams of sodium chloride was dissolved in 250 ml of water. Calculate molarity. Data given in weight, which 250 ml. So use this principle. Okay, na? Direct use that principle. Okay, here what is the principle? M is equal. First you write molarity principle. Now you write molarity principle. Okay, W M into 1000 by V in milliliters. What we need here? What is the W?
5.85 grams.
Okay, you have to calculate molecular weight of sodium chloride. What is the molecular weight of sodium chloride? Sodium 23, chlorine 35.5. How much? 58.5. Okay, here weight is 5.85 grams. Okay, molecular weight is 58.5 grams into 1000 by
250.
Okay, 250. Okay, here 250 ones are 250 fours are. Yes, sir. Here 5.85 ones are 5 tens are. Yes, sir. Next to here 2 twos are 4. 2 fives are 10. That means 2 by 5. 2 by 5 means how much? 0.4 moles per Here data given in milliliters. So write moles per milliliter. Okay, these are the different problems. Classroom. Okay, I will discuss about this topic in classroom also. I will use more and more problems. Okay, based on this molarity. Then in continuation, we'll see the some more formulas of molarity. Where is it? Okay, here you take this principle. Calculate the weight. Here also you calculate the weight. If you know the molarity, then okay, if you know the molarity, how to calculate the weight? This is used for the preparation of the solution. For example, 0.2 m concentrated solution, 0.3 m concentrated solution. How we prepare that much concentration? Okay, how we prepare such type of concentrated solution? Okay, just they are taking salt. Okay, by using weight. Okay, that is dissolved in water and we prepare the that much concentrated solution. Okay, how we know the weight of that solution? For example, 0.1 m sodium carbonate solution. How we prepare the 0.1 m sodium carbonate solution? By using this principle, okay, I will give principle. By using that principle, we will calculate, we will prepare various types of solution with their specific concentrations. Okay, here, cross multiplication. You have to calculate weight of solute. Okay, now weight of solute is equal to Can you cross multiplication? What is the cross multiplication? Okay, here write molecular weight, molarity into molecular weight into V in liters. In liters. By using this principle, we calculate weight of this solute by 1. Neglect the 1. Okay, by using this principle, we will calculate the weight of the solute if data are given in liters. We'll do some problems on this. Okay, here also same weight of solute. Weight of solute is equal to cross multiplication. What is the cross multiplication? Molarity into molecular weight into V in milliliters by 1000. Cross multiplication by 1000. By using this principle, we will calculate the weight of this solute data given in 250 ml, 500 ml, okay, 750 ml, 600 ml, 400 ml, like that. If data are given in liters, 2 liters, 4 liters, 5 liters, we use this one. Okay, if data are given in milliliters, we use this one. Based on these two principles, we will do the sum problems. One problem, each one. Okay, here, how 0.m sodium carbonate to, okay, here instead of this one, 0.1m 2 liters sodium carbonate solution was prepared. Okay, how 0.1 2 liters of sodium carbonate solution was prepared. That means, okay, how sodium carbonate solution? Solution means sodium carbonate dissolved into water. Okay, here data given in 2 liters na water. Okay, here concentration of sodium carbonate, molarity of sodium carbonate given. Molecular weight of the sodium carbonate, we know. You calculate the weight of the sodium carbonate. Weight of the sodium carbonate. That much weight you take and dissolve in 2 liters. Then we'll get 0.1 m sodium carbonate solution. Okay, here, what is the principle? Data given liter na, use this one. Weight of solute is equal to molarity into molecular weight into V in liters. This much. Leave it one. Molarity how much?
0.1.
What is the molecular weight of sodium carbonate? It's important. Sodium carbonate molecular weight. Sodium. How many sodiums are there? 2. 2 into 23. Plus. How many carbons are there? Only 1. 12. Plus. How many oxygens are there? 3. 3 into 16. Total 106. The molecular weight of sodium carbonate is 106. So, 106 into 2 liters. Okay, 0.1 into 106 means 10.6 into 2. Okay, into 2 is equal to 10.6 into 2. Okay, 10 to the 20. And here 6 into 2, 12. 12 means 21.2 grams. 21.2 grams. Weight of solute here. Weight of solute here, 21.2 grams. That means, you weigh the 21.2 grams of sodium carbonate dissolving 2 liters of water. 2 liters of water. What you get? The concentration of that solution, the molarity of that solution is 0.1 m. Okay, the molarity of that one is 0.1 m. Okay, laboratory will prepare like that one. Okay, then I want to discuss one more problem here. How 0.2 m, how 0.2 m 500 ml
urea solution was prepared.
How will prepare? Okay, 0.8 again, same, but data given in 500. Data given in 500. Okay, I am taking simple numbers. For our understanding purpose, I took here simple numbers. But in examination point of view, they may give 372 ml, 375 ml, okay, 3 like that, 275, 250, 260, 270, like that, they will 1075 ml, they mention like that. For our understanding purpose, I am taking here 2 liters, 500 ml. Okay, na? Okay, here see, data given in milliliters, na? What is the principle? Weight of the solute is equal. Weight of solute is equal. Okay, molarity into molecular weight into V in ml by 1000. Here what molarity, how much? 0.22. Next, molecular weight of the urea. Already I gave in data. Already I gave. We calculate the molecular weight of the urea. Okay, just here I am calculating molecular weight of urea is equal to, what is the formula of urea? NH2CO NH2. Okay, just write this formula. How many nitrogens are there?
2 nitrogens.
How many hydrogens are there?
4
hydrogens. How many carbons?
1.
How many oxygens?
1.
Finish. Then write. How many nitrogens are there here?
2
nitrogens.
2.
Nitrogen atomic weight? 14. 2 into 14?
28.
Plus. 4. Hydrogen 4.
4.
Plus. Carbon 12. 5. Oxygen 16. Total 16. Okay, the molecular weight of urea is 60. Okay, right here 60. 60. And here volume. Volume given in?
500
ml. By
1000.
Okay, now. Then 500 ones are 500
two ones
are 2 ones are 2
30
is 60. Okay, here what we have? 0.2 into 30. 0.2 into 30 means? Okay, here. How much? Okay, 30 into 0.2. 30 into 2? 60. 60 means?
6.
6 grams. Okay, here. What is that? Molecular weight of urea is 60 grams. 6 grams. If 6 grams of urea was dissolved in 500 ml of water, we'll get 0.2 m concentrated solution. 0.2 m concentrated solution. This is a calculation of weight of solute if you know the molarity. If you know the weight of the solute, already we calculated molarity. These are the different problems. Okay, in continuation, okay, I will give one more problem to you. One more principle to you. Okay, here. See here. According to the molarity principle, molarity directly proportional to the, indirectly proportional to the value. Indirectly proportional to the value. From this principle, molarity indirectly proportional to the value. Okay, here, you remove proportionality constant, you put the any constant, K by V. K by V. This is the proportionality constant. You remove the proportionality constant and put the another constant. K is a simple constant. Don't think about it. Okay. It is also useless here. We need this one. Okay. What is the K? K is equal to
M.
K is equal to
M.
M means molarity. V means
value.
solution contain, if any solution contain, okay, if any solution contain two types of solutions, two types of individual solutions. Solution means mixture. Suppose for example, its solution contain milk and water. Milk solution, water solution. Milk solution molarity different, water solution molarity is different. Milk value is different, water value is different. If solution contain two types of solutions, two types of solutions are two types of liquids, we use this one. First solution is indicated with M1. Second, value of first solution indicated with V1. Okay, second one. In value of molarity of second one, second solution indicated with M2. Value indicated with V1. Okay, here K is equal to MV or MV is equal to K. So here M1 V1 is equal to what? K1. M2 V2 is equal to what? K2. K1, K2 both are constants. Both are constants. So M1 V1 is equal to M2 V1. M1 V1 is equal to M2. Obviously, M1 V1 both are constant. M1 V1 is equal to constant. M2 V2 is equal to constant. Okay, both are constants. So M1 V1 is equal to obviously M2 V2. Okay, here based on this, I will give you one formula. Okay, here I will give the one formula. Okay, here 0.1 m hydrochloric acid dissolving 20 ml of sulfuric acid. Okay, here calculate molarity of sulfuric acid. See here, hydrochloric acid liquid, sulfuric acid also liquid. Two liquids are there. Okay, if you know the concentration of one liquid, then you will calculate the concentration of another liquid. Okay, what is the principle? This one. M1 V1 is equal to M2 V2. What we need here? M1. That means hydrochloric acid is 1, sulfuric acid is 2. Consider like that. Okay, M1 is equal to molarity, na? Okay, molarity of hydrochloric acid 0.1. Okay, value of hydrochloric acid is 10 ml. Okay, na? 10 ml. Okay, here M2. What? M2 is what? You have to calculate. Calculate molarity of sulfuric acid. Next, your V2 is equal to 20 ml. Okay, if you know the three terms, then you calculate the fourth term. Then you calculate the fourth term. You calculate the M2. M1V1 is equal to M2 or M2V2 is equal to M1V1. Okay, then M2 is equal to what? M2 is equal to M1V1 by V2. What is the M1? 0.1. What is the V1?
10 ml.
10 ml by 20. Okay, here 1's are
2's.
Okay, 0.1 by 2. 1 by 2 means 1 by 20. Okay, remove the point and put the 0 here. 1 by 20. 1 by 20 is equal to 0.05. Okay, 0.05 m. This is the molarity of sulfuric acid. Molarity of sulfuric acid. Okay, here we will calculate molarity. If you know the concentration of one term, then you calculate the concentration of other. If you know the value also we calculate. Here we calculate value also. Okay, this is about the molarity. Some more are there, neutralization reaction. For the molarity, neutralization reactions also is there. Okay, that is for mean level or under level. Practical also, in practical exam, in practical also we have that one. Okay, just I'm giving one principle. M1 V1 by N1 is equal to N2 V2 by N2. N means number of moles involved reactant, number of moles of solid involved, solid or solid involved in the reaction. Molarity, volume, it is a number of moles of one term. Here N2 is molarity, V2 is volume, N2 is number of moles of second term. Number of moles of second term. Okay. This is not required for here. Okay, this is the complete discussion of the molarity. Complete discussion of the molarity. And in continuation, we will see the molality, normality, molality, mole fraction, all those. We will see in continuation. Continuation video. Thank you.